Hey everybody, what's up? And in today's video, I just want to talk about a few things that is probably stopping you to getting to your success. So many people every day to day, through their day-to-day lives are completely distracted. They're obsessed with distraction. So many people, you don't realize it, but you're so much more powerful than you think you are. If you're laser focused on your dreams, you can become an expert as anything as long as you apply yourself fully and truly. And in society today, everyone's trying to divert your focus so we never become successful. I mean, just to start off, do you really know what you want? And are you really laser focused? Because when you're laser focused, what this means is when what your goals are, it distracts you from the rest of your life. So many things distract us, but these things don't matter. Being informed is great, however, does it really matter about who and so and so is doing about any TV shows, any reality TV shows, or politics even? It doesn't dramatically change your life. You need to learn to be obsessed with your life, not others' lives. So these are all really called convenient distractions. You need to learn to obsess over yourself, obsess over your own life, get focused on your own goals, look at yourself, narrow things down to the people, the certain few people that you like, the certain few people that you resonate with. Maybe listen to them when you're in the car, listen to them when you're at the gym as much as you want, but those other times you got to be executing. These channels, these podcasts, these videos, they're stealing your dreams. Things in life that don't matter distract us, such as failures, bad thoughts, overthinking, gossiping. You need to stop being distracted by movies, TV, Netflix, video games. And I mean, are you distracted by things not mattering in your life and your big goals? And a lot of you guys are willing participants. A lot of us are willing participants in our own distractions. If you're really obsessed with your goals will distract you from all the real distractions. Eliminate all distractions, then you got to sacrifice. So you really got to start off with identifying what you want to be, who you want to be, and what you really want. Then you got to start eliminating all distractions, and then the other side of the coin is sacrifice. You need to embrace the suffering. Suffering is an indicator of progress toward our dreams. The lack of sacrifice and suffering means the non-existence of a good life and, more importantly, an amazing dream. Kind of like for those of you that go to the gym, you already accept the fact that you're going to suffer before you go to the gym and you make it a habit. So many people go to the gym every way. No one every day. No one goes into the gym knowing that there will be no discomfort or pain. In some way, people know that they're going to be suffering. And in some way, when everyone's at the gym, they're suffering in some way, shape, or form, whether it's sweating, pushing themselves on heavy weight, straining, they're hurt from the previous day, they're suffering, they're breathing heavy. You know before you go, but yet most of us in life are worried about suffering, worried about sacrificing. People worry that sacrificing in pain, and when this happens, we wonder if it's worth it. We think if, oh, maybe this is a sign this isn't working. At the gym, you never think that. Breaking down, suffer, and you sacrifice to grow again. You break down your muscles, they'll rebuild. But you'll have to suffer to rebuild. You actually feel better at the gym when you sacrifice. At the end of that workout, that was insanely hard. You feel so good. You feel so much better when you sacrifice. Your body is a metaphor for your life. You think, oh, some sacrifice, some struggle comes in the way. And you think, oh, maybe I'm not cut out for this. Maybe I can't do it. Maybe this doesn't work. You're doubting yourself. And doubt is a huge distraction. You're supposed to suffer and you're supposed to sacrifice. The question you want to ask yourself is, what are you willing to sacrifice? Failing, pain, anxiety, risking our relationships, finances, time, money. The price you will pay for not making your dream come true is incredibly smaller than the price you pay if you never sacrifice something. Most people try to negotiate the price in their head. Can I do this? Should I keep doing this? People will start telling you, dude, this isn't worth it. It's not worth what you're doing. You shouldn't, this is costing you too much. Stop negotiating in your head. Stop letting other people negotiate the price in your head as well. Set the bar for what you're gonna sacrifice, because people will negotiate this for you and they'll tell you, oh no, this is too much, man. It's not gonna work. Negotiate now. Negotiate your price now. But on the flip side, don't negotiate price, negotiate and look at your worth. Accept the suffering, accept the sacrifice, and then go get what you want in your life. Stop negotiating your price and start looking at worth. It's a freeing experience to totally commit, and it's extremely powerful. People around you are saying it's costing too much, it's costing you too much, it's costing you too much. No, it's worth it. The outcome is worth it. Decide in advance what it's going to cost. Negotiate if it's worth it. If you really want something bad enough, anything is worth it. You need to focus on worth, not the price. On the other side of things, sacrifice and laser focus is your path to succeeding your dream. And really, if you think about it, when you're laser focused and when you're sacrificing something, you're really the most happy. When you're not sacrificing, when you're playing the easy route, when you're distracted, that is when you're not happy. So I challenge everyone to obsess with your own distraction. Be obsessed with your goals. Be obsessed with your life. Execute, violently execute everything that you can do to get closer to your goal. Eliminate all distractions and then sacrifice. Eliminate distractions, execute violently, and then you have to sacrifice. Embrace the suffering. Like I said, this is an indicator of progress towards our dreams. The lack of sacrifice means the non-existence of an amazing dream. Let me say that again. The lack of suffering and sacrifice means the non-existence of an amazing dream. You have to execute. You have to eliminate distractions, obsess on your life, obsess on your dreams, and just execute like hell. So I hope this video helped out for some of you guys. If you have any questions, please make sure to let me know. Violently execute today, get closer to your dreams, and I'll talk to you guys in the next one.